church choirs just fell into the pines. And I love you like the mountains love the way the morning opens, too soft and bright, greeting from the sun. So it make you stay. Keep it all inside, and I let you know how much I love you every day. Darling, will you stay right here? This part's hard. Off of my soul.
Had I known that that new song we started and was inspired by a guy I think Alan wrote it a long time ago. Ladies and gentlemen, back here on the drums to my right. Keep the rhythm, steady as a clock. Everyone, thank you on the hill of the rock. It smells so good it'll kill you, so we call him John Wayne Macy. The lead singer of the potentially award-winning honky-tonk band El Dorado. The gem of the Jewel City from Huntington, West Virginia, Mr. Hot Rodney Elkins. Too much land for just one mic stand. I don't know if you noticed, but there's a lot of things to hit up here. Over here on the other set of drums to my left, hanging out with us while I ain't got nothing else better to do. Looks like a butterfly, sings like a bee, sings like an angel in the good Lord's key of G. From Brussels, Kentucky, the Honorable Colonel Miles Millie. He really is a colonel. He's a Kentucky colonel. It doesn't demand nearly as much responsibility as some other colonelships you could have. But it's really cool to say, and you get to say you're a colonel. We got three colonels. He's a colonel, I'm a colonel, these two are from West Virginia. This is a song about being homesick. I wrote this in outside of Seattle not too long ago when I was homesick and it didn't help anything. Further away. me and the boys first got together, we got ourselves a circus. We started in Huntington, West Virginia. We would leave Huntington, West Virginia. We would go to Charleston, West Virginia. In Charleston, West Virginia, we would go to Chillicothe, Ohio. In Chillicothe, Ohio, we would go to Circleville, Ohio. First time we ever played in Chillicothe, Ohio, we met a fellow that gave us a big bag full of gummies, and he wanted to party. We didn't want to party, but we did want those gummies, so we hung out a little bit, we had a couple of drinks, and we said thank you very much to these gummies, but we've got to go, because we've got to get up in the morning and go the long, hard 15 minutes down the road to Circleville. So we woke up at 10, and we got there at 10:15, and by 10:45, we saw all the sights that were to see in Circleville, Ohio. And so there was nothing else to do until 7 o'clock loaded, and we decided that we'd have ourselves one of those gummies. And we went to the Circleville Public Library. And I can guarantee you we're the quietest people in the Circleville Public Library. 7 o'clock when we loaded in, we did sound check, and we didn't have anything else to do until 10 o'clock, so we decided we'd have ourselves another gummy. I don't know if you know a whole lot about gummies. Edibles, but there's a certain equation that goes in to committing to edibles, especially when they're random things that were made by somebody's buddy and they brought them to you. Those things are how much have you drank, how little have you drank, how much have you eaten, how little have you eaten, how much have you slept, how do you feel today psychologically? And that particular day, my edible threshold was somewhere between 1 and 2. And it was a little too late to do anything about it. I could have told you my name, I could have told you my father's name, I couldn't have told you the chords that went to any of the words that I couldn't remember anyways. And so in act of desperation, I turned around and I looked at Rodney and I said, "Hey Rodney, you wanna play some songs?" And for about 20 to 25 minutes, Rodney played solid country gold. And I sat over there and knocked the bar with my head against the wall trying to get my shit together. And they had us back. They had us back a lot. We made a lot of friends and we had a lot of really good times. And we all talked about that one time when I couldn't remember any of the words in any of my songs. We had a lot of fun. And that particular set doesn't have anything to do with this song. But I wrote this song in the Circleville Public Library. Sidewalk, taking in factory smells, hitting those tents, looking out the window. bus route.
Thank you.
about being on the road and slowly losing your mind. These things tend to happen over and over and over and over.
Only had a couple drinks last night. A few good hits from an Empire.
deal with that all the while maintaining a monogamous relationship. It's called Ever Loving Hand. Talk about my experience anymore. next song is another song about the human experience. I didn't write it, it's a Shel Silverstein song. My favorite version is Dr. Hooks. This is a different version. While it's not all completely about whacking off, it does have a line about it. So I have to pair them together and get them out of the way. It usually sounds way better if it's in tune. Today's been a really good day, man. It's always a pleasure to see Laidback Country Picker. Mr. William Athene. And all the great people that they have around them at all times, playing music with them and hanging out. It's great company. It's always good to see it. And here's what song I was telling you about, with the wagon up on. I'm gonna make it. I graduated from Paintsville High School. That's how my mom felt about it too. I went to Western Kentucky University. I say I went there when I was older, more accurate. And I went there because it was the closest I could get to Nashville and still keep my keys running. Which I don't know if you guys have anything like that, but in Kentucky it's called keys and you get like so much money for every good grade you make. So I didn't have a lot of it, but I wanted to keep it. You get to keep it as long as you go to university in Kentucky. I spent most of my time coming down here and not getting a gig anywhere. So I had to go home because half the battle was doing your homework and showing up. So I went back home and I got a job at the local Sears. We were about half the size of this bar, which is still pretty big for a bar, but it's pretty fucking small for a Sears. We had a couple lawnmowers, we had a couple refrigerators, and the majority of the stuff that we delivered to your house, you got online and it came to our store and I delivered it because I was a pretty piss poor salesman, so they put me on deliveries. And when we would go on deliveries, we would take the long way around to get there because that's how you get paid the most for doing the least amount of work, because you take the long way around. If you don't remember anything out of the night, be sure to remember work smarter, not harder. I did deliveries with a fellow named Joe. Joe's an interesting character full of tall tales and flat out lies, and mostly lies, and I was alright, because we got along just fine. And we would take the long way to Martin County when we had deliveries there. We would go by this particular holler called White House Road. That's where Joe spent most of his time. So I wrote this song for Joe, I wrote it for Sears, and I wrote this for White House Road.
Thank you.
Louisville. This is a song I wrote about, I'm just relaxing. Good story, right? Which is for you guys. shoulder deep, best never see the two of them together. But it's hard to keep an eye on her when you're working all the time. There are things he needs to tend to, and the bills the bank keeps him. Four zeros on the end, he puts a further to the right. Like a freight train on sorrow, that's moving in a car. There's a tunnel up forever, north and never in the light. The days are dark, down in the holler. The days are He needs no introduction. But he's been country ever since he was a current savage. Over here on my right, this late back country group. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my absolute, hands down, without a shadow of a doubt, favorite Hannah Montana song. I came in like a guys, we got one more for you here, and after that, it's a Marvel movie drink. I'll have the credits. I appreciate y'all coming out. You've had an absolute blast here the last 3 hours. We got to meet a lot of really cool people. We got to hang out with a lot of really old friends we don't get to see too often. It's been an absolute blessing to be here. Thank you so much. This isn't Hannah Montana, but this is kind of like the Miley Cyrus of this time. This is the Charlie Daniels story.